Did you know that you are made of trillions of cells, but only around 200 different types?
For example, the cells inside your cheek are made up of stratified, scabby nepotism cells designed to handle constant abrasion. These type of cells are not only in your cheeks, but also in your vagina and anus as well. Hey guys, I'm Christine Sedelko and I'm here with ASAP Science, and we're talking about why your body is amazing and mine is amazinger. You, Jessica.
When you were an embryo, the first opening that developed was your anus. That's right, you were once just a butthole. That means you are a deuterostome, and so is a sea urchin.
Christine, how much gas do you think exits your anus in one day?
Yeah, you'd like to know that, pervert. Science says that today, about half a liter of gas will exit your anus. And I say that too. I just said it. Because it was written, that was my line.
If this feels like too much, don't worry, as your brain already does a pretty good job of censoring content, like your nose. Your nose is in your field of vision, and each eye sees the nose in a different position. The region that is blocked by the nose for one eye is visible for the other eye, and the brain constructs a unified image, and therefore you ignore your nose. But your nose is so powerful. In fact, if you convert your nose receptor neurons into binary code, it's the equivalent of 46 petabytes. That's more information than every movie ever made up to 2017. Convert all the cells in your body and it would add up to 91.44 zettabytes, or 10 to the 21 bytes.
Scientists hypothesized that during pregnancy you gave some cells to your mom. I just give her attitude. This process is called fetomaternal
microchimerism.
I think I got it. This process is called fetomaternal microchimerism. Microsoft. Scientists have found fetal cells in various maternal tissues that can persist for decades. The reasons for this is unclear, but one hypothesis is that the baby is trying to increase its chances of survival.
When your heart stops, your brain actually knows that you're dead. A study that investigated individuals who were pronounced dead but later resuscitated found that 46% had memories of the event. 2% could even recall seeing and hearing actual events that could be corroborated with hospital doctors and nurses. These findings are further supported by a study of rats whose hearts had stopped and were declared dead. However, the rats were experiencing a surge of brainwaves in the period after their hearts had flatlined.
Your dog is running towards a busy street of traffic.
Pancake, no!
Your plane back from Amsterdam just fell 200,000 feet in the air.
Are we in the Earth's crust? No! 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 Ah! Now that I'm stressed, my body sees this as a risk, causing my blood to thicken, just like my sweet, sweet similar to when you are physically injured to prevent blood loss. But if you do actually get cut, the injury has a better chance of healing during the daytime.
Our skin has cells called fibroblasts. If you're scratched, these cells fill the void and allow for new skin to grow. Scientists have discovered that these cells have their own circadian rhythm and act much more quickly during the day. In fact, those who suffered a nighttime burn took an average of 11 days longer to heal.
Many people have been told that the tongue is the strongest muscle in the body, but this is wrong. It's wrong, and I won't stand for it. First of all, your tongue is not a single muscle, but actually a conglomerate of 8 muscles forming a muscle system. In actuality, the muscles that have the most brute force are your quadriceps on the front of your thighs and the gluteus maximus in the rear.
What other lies have you been told? 5 senses? Though scientists can't agree on how many, they do agree that there are more than 5. Like proprioception, which is our ability to perceive body and limb position. It's why you can close your eyes and touch your nose, or switch between the gas and brake pedal without looking. Or nociception, our ability to perceive pain or harmful stimuli. Every morning, you are about 1.5 to 2 centimeters taller than at night. The pressure of the day, walking, running, and general living, causes compression in the cartilage in your spine and joints, and when we go to sleep at night, the pressure eases.
Okay, thank you so much, Christine. We love you. That was hilarious. That was amazing.
Hope
thanks for disseminating science.
If you want to check out Christine's channel, obviously.
Don't.
Yeah, don't. That's not what this is about.
Ooh,
but
reverse psychology. Upcoming video.
Did you enjoy preaching some science today?
Yes. Just a disclaimer, I got a D in freshman biology. Do not trust anything I said. And have a great day.
All right, see you later.
Bye.
Thank you.